There are 11 data types that routerized variables can have. Let's have a closer look to understand them better. First up, we get a variable with no defined value, which is the first data type, nil. There isn't much to see, but I have prepared a little script snippet that establishes the variable, prints it using the put command, and the output is an empty line. But then it also prints the output of a command called typeof. This command returns the data type of any variable, and in this case, it is nothing. Moving on, we got num, which is our 64-bit integer. When we run a similar little script, you can see that the output of the typeof command is simply num. It is the only number data type that we have, so when doing math operations like division, we have to keep in mind that there is no floating data point. If a mathematical operation results in something with a decimal point, it will simply get rounded. Normally, people don't want to do advanced math operations on their routers, so this shouldn't be much of a setback. But if you need to do a precise math operation, you can easily work around the limitation. For example, if you want to divide a number with the precision of one decimal place, you could simply multiply the dividend by 10 and remember that the rightmost digit is the first decimal place. There is also the modulo operator, which you could use to generate a readable output with multiple decimal places. A fun fact about the num data type is that you could also use bytes in hexadecimal format as input. Then we got bool. Not much to it. It just stores a single bit of information that resembles true or false, and hence there are only two outputs that this variable could have. Strings will take up more memory, but they can store any text that you need. Since this is scripting for routers, the next four data types are for storing networking information. IP type can efficiently store IP version for addresses. IP prefix is slightly larger and is intended to store the subnet information, but really it stores the same data as IP plus the subnet. In the same manner, we have the IP6 type. And of course, an IP6 prefix to store the subnet information. And then we have a special routerized variable called ID. It always starts with a star, but it is just a hexadecimal number. These are generally used as immutable references to configurable items. For example, an interface could be referenced using its list number and name, but both of those could change breaking your script. So the ID is a much better way to reference things, but they are usually not displayed anywhere. If you would like to find out the ID, you will need to use the get command. The information that is returned will contain the ID. Now it is also possible to store time as a variable. So if I record midnight as a variable, it works just fine, but there is a quirk. If you work with this data type and at any point the value reaches 24 hours, it will no longer return 24. Instead, it will turn into 1D00. This is because the data type stores date and time together, but as long as the date part is all zeros, they don't get displayed. If you want to use this data type to keep track of things over time, you will have to parse for the full format that starts with weeks followed by days and ends with time. The weeks number will get pretty large, but 10,000 is just an example and it would actually be referencing a far future. Routerize uses the Unix time, which starts on January 1st, 1970. Today's date converted to time data type would result in something like week 2800. Finally, the last data type is array. Working with arrays deserves a separate video, but here is how you can create them. To define one, you need to place your values inside curly brackets, and of course, you have to separate them. You can use the commas in the input if you like, but the output will return semicolons. What is interesting about this data type is that it can also work similarly to dictionaries in Python, so you could also define one using key value pairs. The funny thing is that you could even mix them, but more on that in the video on working with arrays. Thank you for watching and have fun scripting!